End of the last debate. My noble friend Lord Cormac refused to take an intervention from me. He's explained that he has to leave his place now. But I was merely going to ask him, as an acknowledged constitutional expert, if he did not think that the ramming of a bill through the House in one day would do more damage to the reputation of this House than these procedural debates that we're having. My Lords, my amendment says that instead of trying to rush this constitutional enormity through in one go. By the way, I don't think a cogent answer has been given to the question of why that should be necessary. And to do so based on a flimsy one-vote majority, 313 to 312, that instead of that, my amendment says we should take two stages today, two stages on another day, and the final two stages on a third day. And that seems to me a reasonable way for this House to go about discussing important matters. I believe it's vital that we debate this hugely important measure as freely as possible, with as many attempts to get it right as we need. And I express my astonishment, my Lords, that so many members opposite, who normally take the view that the purpose of this House is to scrutinise legislation properly, now suddenly want to abandon their principles and shove through a measure that creates dangerous precedents for the future. This is precisely the sort of case where we need to tread with care. Now we're being asked to take a whole bill through in a few hours, a bill to defy everything that the people asked us to do. Because yes, as my noble friend Lord Forsyth said earlier today, this could lead to a slippery slope to tyranny. If ever there was a time, my Lords, they laugh, but that is exactly the point my noble friend made, that bit by bit we are disentangling a very delicate constitution.